Mr. Tarrou. Okay, we're getting our logarithms, we graph logarithms, we introduce the basic structure of logarithms and how when you take the log of a number you do get an exponent, such as log of 100 equals 2, and the reason why is if we just write the word log with no base indicated, that is base 10. Well, the log of 100 is equal to 2 because 10 squared equals 100. We also talked about how the log function was the inverse of the exponential form. You log 100, you get 2. You do 10 to the second, you get back to 100. Okay, at any rate, we want to today talk about expanding and contracting. We're going to just manipulate log expressions, getting us ready algebraically to start solving equations with the variable and the exponent, which will be the next video, or the next couple of videos. So, we need to learn how to break apart or sometimes put back together these log functions to aid us in the next section that we're going to take a look at. So no solving equations today, just manipulating expressions and occasionally simplifying some logs along the way that we can do in our head. Okay, log base b of m times n. I want to rewrite this expression so that both the m and the n, both of those factors, have their own log function. Well, inside of this multiplication, inside of this log function, you have a multiplication that has a common base of b. Well, remember, what do you get out of log equations or a log function? You get an exponent. So your properties of logarithms are going to be very similar to when you work with like bases and you're working with your exponents, such as x to the fifth times x squared. Well, when you multiply with common bases, you add the exponents. Well, out of a log function, you get an exponent. And the multiplication within this log has a common base of b. So if I want to separate this multiplication and write log base b of m and log base b of n, what am I going to do with that? How do I separate that? Well, from a log function, you get an exponent. From a log function, you get an exponent. And when you have multiplication within a common base, very similar to your rules with regular exponents, you add them. When you multiply with like bases, you add the exponents. So there's the first property of logarithms, based on what you've known, hopefully, about multiplying like bases when you're in exponential form. Well, what do you do when you divide like bases and you're learning exponents? You've been taught that you subtract. So when you have division and a like base, you subtract the exponents. Logarithms give you exponents. So the log base b of m, log base b of m divided by n is going to be equal to log base b of m minus log base b of n. Again, very similar to when you're dividing like bases in exponential form. Okay, now, again, this might go against our idea of order of operations, but within a logarithm, when you do the log of a number, you get an exponent. So this is kind of like an exponent raised to another exponent. Like if I were to write x to the fifth, then have that to another power of 2, where these exponents are stacked. Well, you would drop that down and write x to the 2 times 5, which is 10. Well, that's the property of logarithm here. It's going to allow us. Logarithms will say you can take, if you take the log of a number that has its own exponent, you can drop that exponent down out front and write it as p times the log base b of m. And again, think of it as, and well, it's not as, it's true. When you take the log of a number, you get an exponent. So this is sort of like power to power property that you would see when you're dealing with just normal exponential form, and those stacked exponents will drop down and you multiply. So you can do the same thing with logarithms. Okay, so there's our three properties of logarithms. I will probably have to erase that at some point to have room for a couple of my examples, but let's start taking some log expressions and breaking them apart, expanding them. So our first one is going to be log base 5 of 5x. So it's a log of two items being multiplied together. Well, when you take the log of two items being multiplied together, common base, you can expand that by doing log base 5 of 5 plus log base 5 of x. Multiplication, common base, you add those exponents, you add those logarithms when you pull it apart. Now occasionally we're going to have some parts of these expressions that can be simplified, and 5 to what power equals 5? When you log 5 using the base of 5, and again, when you log a number you get an exponent, so 5 to what exponent gives you 5? Well, 1. So it's 1 plus log base 5 of x. So we got done expanding that one. Next, we've got log base 3 of 27x squared. Same thing, very similar to the last question. It's a log of two items being multiplied together. So we're going to expand that multiplication, and we do have a power of 2, but we are not going to be able to bring that down out front until it's exactly in this format of log with the leading coefficient of 1, a single item with that exponent. Basically, when you're expanding your log expressions, you're going to deal with this, let's call it power to power rule, last. Okay? So this is going to be log base 3 of 27 plus log base 3 of x squared. All right, now, again, when you log a number, you get an exponent, and it's an exponent of this base. So 3 to what power gives you 27? The log base 3 of 27 is 3/9/27. Okay, now we got 3 plus the log base 3 of x squared, and now we've got that leading coefficient of 1. We're taking the log of sort of like a single factor that has its own exponent, power of 2, and that can now be dropped down out front, and we get 3 plus 2 times the log base 3 of x. And that expression has now been completely expanded and evaluated a little bit with the log base 3 of 27. Don't worry about working this out if it doesn't come out to be a whole number. At this point in your textbook, you should be giving logarithms that can be done in your head without the aid of a calculator. And if they don't come out evenly, then yes, you will have to make you do with a calculator. Okay, log base 5 of the square root of x over 125. We're going to deal with that square root in a minute. You really should not work with radicals in that radical form. They're actually much more complicated. You should rewrite them with parentheses and use a fractional exponent where the top is the power and the bottom is the root. I'll go over that in just a second. But the first thing I want to do is split up that division. Division signs do act as grouping symbols, not that there's much going on with this fraction. So we want to split that big fraction bar first and then take care of the top and the bottom separately. And my students, you know, that do tend to make a little bit of a mistake on these problems are the ones that try and do more than one step at a time. You really want to do these log function problems piece by piece by piece. Don't try to do too much in your head. It will usually lead to some careless mistakes. So it's the top minus the log of the bottom. And again, there is a power of 5 in 125, so this will work out to be evenly. 5 to what power is going to give you 125? What exponent will you get out of the log function? 5, 25, and 125. So that'll be 3. And now, this looks like it's done. It looks like it's expanded as much as possible. But if I write this radical symbol with its index of 2, and the x having a power of 1, that is going to be log base 5 of x to the 1/2. Well, now I'm taking the log of a single factor, an item that has its own exponent, and that's kind of like, again, your power to power rule when you're dealing with exponential form, and you're allowed to bring that exponent down out front. This is the property that's so handy when we start to solve equations with the variable in the exponent. That's why logs are so handy. Not that we're doing any of that today. Okay. Bam! Got it done. Fully expanded. Moving on. Haven't done any natural logs yet. So let's take a look at that. We've got the natural log of e to the third over 7. Don't be freaked out by this little ln. That's just another notation. It's shorthand for log base e. I'll expand that out just as a teaching tool here in a second. But again, first I want to split up that division. So we got natural log of e to the third minus natural log of 7. Now, there's a couple of things I can do right now. I can pull the 3 out front with this power-to-power rule thing, but I want to show you a different item going on here, because natural log, this is standard shorthand, you should get used to it, but natural log is log base e, and then it's log base e of e to the third minus log base e to the 7th. And there's no reason to really write it like this, except I'm trying to highlight to you that ln is log base e, and e is 2.718. That number shows up a lot in nature and engineering in certain fields, and it's 2.718. It's kind of like pi. Okay, well, we have this log has a base, and a logging a number with exactly the same base, and I explained in a recent video at the introduction to logarithms why these do cancel out, and they do. So the log base e, logging a number with its own base of e, those are going to cancel out, and the 3 is simply going to drop down, and I'm going to go back to the ln, because this is not, it's a good teaching notation, but no one really uses this. Log base e is natural log. All right, done. Let's do a couple more. I think I'm going to have to do a separate video for condensing these expressions, because I'm sure I'm getting close to running out of time. Log base b of x to the fourth y squared over z. Another question where there's a lot of division and items going on. Again, we're going to split up this fraction bar first. So it's going to be log base b of x to the fourth y squared minus log base b of z. Great. So I haven't worried about trying to split it all up at once, and sometimes you can do that and it's correct, and sometimes you'll do that and you will miss a critical step and cause a minor error. I'm just showing the division bar with all of the top and all of the bottom, not trying to do two steps at once. Now, we have the log of two items being multiplied together, and that fact that there's two items here with their own exponents, which is also why I'm not pulling the 4 and the 2 out yet. So we get log base b of x to the 4th, splitting this multiplication, giving each one their own logarithm, will be plus log base b, and there's my alarm telling me that yes, I was getting close on time, minus log base b of z, and now that I have these terms completely isolated, I can drop the 4 down, take care of that power property last. And now that expression is fully expanded, and that's pretty much the last one I wanted to do. I will do one more expansion in the next video, because I want to show one where there's a square root all of this. I'm Mr. True. I'm out. Thank you for watching very, very much.